Hi everybody and welcome to Montana. It's a gorgeous day to ride, and before we ride we're going to finish installing the Barkbuster guides. So I already did this part, so this one is already mounted. It was the easiest one to do. As you can see, we have a very sturdy aluminum core right there, and the plastic mount, the guard itself, is mounted onto the side here, and two screws on the inside. Now the problem came mounting the right side. The right side was pretty tricky, and this is what I recommend doing, and it's what worked for me. Now I had to move the brake fluid tank to the left. I had to unscrew this, move it, and then place the bracket inside and then push it back. Once inside, this one will not come off, right? Now that I have it, and it's not marked in the instructions for the Africa Twin, so I had to figure that one out myself, and I couldn't find any other video, so I'm making this one for you guys. Somebody has the same problem. So I mounted this part. That's the easy part. Just follow the instructions that they're given with the Barkbusters. It's easy to do. This was the most complicated part. Once you have that, tools are simple. Wrench, Allen screw. This is pretty much all you need, and I will write the numbers later for so you don't waste too much time. And then we're going to mount this. So phase one, the other part of the bracket, the support, we're gonna enter here. Remember that the short screw goes on top. Oops. There we go. The long one on the bottom. We're not gonna screw it all the way, leave it a little loose, make it easier for us. Thank you. Now we're gonna lower this a little bit. That's it. So the Barkbuster kit does not give you a lot of room to play, so you have to kind of fine-tune it and find the exact spot. So that's why I'm leaving pretty much everything loose except for the tank. I don't need that anymore, hopefully. So we'll leave it all loose. Want to start screwing everything from this side, and before you do, don't forget to grab your weight. It's the one that replaces the original one from Honda. This was the original one. Unfortunately, it's not blue. I like my blue, wish I had it, but anyway, we have it now. I know somebody that forgot it and wasted 20 minutes without the weight. That somebody was me. There we go. Need to be a little bit of a contortionist. There we go. Don't do that. All right. Gotta make sure that the other side is correct. Yep. Forgetting anything else. Look at this. Yeah, perfect. much better, right? Much better. Look at that. Look at this beauty. All right. I have a feeling this video is going to take a long time to edit. All right. Hey, it's my first motorcycle maintenance video. gonna check all the screws after about 50 miles, make sure they're all in place. All right. Right, the hard part is done. One more here. There you go. Now it feels solid. Now we mount the guard itself. Okay, so again, it will be attached on two points. That's one screw, and there's two screws right here. All right, this one will have the barred, the core slide in here. There you go, we'll hold it. I can just hold it right there in place. I'm going to start securing. The big screw first. It was a good idea to put this on rubber. It's a little flexible. Sure the screw is flat. It is. And from the inside, here we have two screws and a little bridge. It helps to have four hands. There we go. Screw number two. All right, and we have the Barkbusters mounted. On the CRF1000L Africa Twin. Thank you, and I'll go for a ride, and hope you get a chance to go for a ride too. See you later. I was forgetting just one little detail. Don't forget your washer, it will go right there. And if you don't use it, the throttle will be stuck up, so you'll be in full throttle, you don't want that. So, since the day I installed my Barkbusters, I took a spill in the mud and I just washed the bike. So, they held really well. I'm gonna show you guys the picture. Be safe out there.